Podcasts on UNCTV.org are made possible through the financial contributions of viewers like you, who invite you to join them in supporting UNC-TV.
Every year, you'll find hundreds of middle school and high school students trying to be North Carolina's best student engineers, researchers, and technologists.
That's what I use to put the LEDs in, put the straw on top of that.
It's the North Carolina Technology Student Association's annual state conference. You'll find a mix of youthful energy, ambition, teamwork, competition, and guts.
I've heard tales of them being on stage holding hands side by side waiting to see who's first, second, and third because they've competed against each other in the same event for multiple years. That's all cool. I mean, that's all cool. That's them going on into adulthood.
TSA competitions cover a wide range of technology-related issues, web design, robots, you name it with computers, they probably have a competition for it. But some competitions are defying obsolescence. Students still learn aerodynamics by grabbing a block of wood and carving a race car.
It makes you feel more like you created it because you get a big block of wood and put it into a piece of art and make it go fast.
You see this as works of art then?
Mm-hmm.
I say in a way, yeah. In a way, definitely, because they're all different.
Speed and design can define some competitions, but old-fashioned research and persuasive presentation define other contests.
And it doesn't shine as much in some areas.
Rhea Taylor and Yingao Zhang attend the North Carolina School of Science and Math and are veteran TSA members.
We're really excited about this. You know, like to us, we're practicing, and I'm like, Ying, you have to be excited. We're going to save the world here. You know.
Well, did you save the world with a display and a presentation to the TSA judges?
I think so.
We're
hopefully. Hopefully, yeah, this will go, hopefully in the future, and so more research will go into it.
So, a reliable source will be ethical.
The competition pressure is like attending a job interview for a job you really want to land. Rhea and Yingao have experience on their side. They're tested. But Alan, Brian, and Tim are a first-time team. They're pitching their engineering concept using one part research and two parts butterflies in the stomach.
We kind of just play to our audience. We kind of notice like their facial features and stuff like that, see if they're smiling, frowning, something like that, hopefully. So,
what kind of facial features did you get during that presentation?
Kind of a little bit scared because they weren't really showing any.
Well, one of them had like the beard and he had like that cool look, and he looked tough, so.
He did look tough. Were they intimidating to look at?
They were intimidating. They kind of looked at me very angry. Well, I don't think they were angry, but just sort of like,
right,
tough, just to sort of like, so they can't show any emotion.
Yeah,
you were talking about you.
That's the idea. the presentation isn't worth as many points as some of the other aspects, but it's vital for the students to learn how to be able to take that kind of pressure, not only for job interviews but for doing research grants and such.
Many students live for the pressure of these 2 days of state competition. Dustin and Daniel could not be stopped in developing their animatronic electrical safety display.
Saturdays, Sundays, after school,
yeah,
you know, 12 o'clock at night, whenever we can.
We've been lucky to have a lot of snow days here in the past few weeks. So, you know, we've been spending all of our time at home just really focusing on this as much as we can.
The TSA competitors say there's something different about making a project for the TSA conference as opposed to being assigned a project by their traditional classroom teacher, where a good letter grade, if not a trophy and recognition, is the reward for sacrifice.
Last year we placed first in this, and so we got to go to nationals and everything and compete, so we know what can come out of this.
And so. You tasted glory.
Yeah, we tasted glory. I mean, we were really striving to make this the best that it can be, and hopefully go to nationals again this year.
Maybe that taste of glory is what makes engineers or teachers of Daniel and Dustin. Could balsa wood be what makes car designers of Cameron and Nathaniel? And it's possible that Yingao and Rhea will solve the world's biggest problem. Time will tell.